Across yourself. Here, here. And then as you go that way, I go this way. And then we both take that side step.
Okay.
Cool. that time?
Yeah, I started to look into it before I finished.
Got it. Okay, so I think, I'm trying to remember now the timing, because there's so many timings that you can do. So once you get her out here, I think it was just slow, quick, and then slow, quick, and quick. So slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, and quick, slow, quick, quick. Yeah, okay. Yeah.
So, you know, when saying it slow, quick, quick, slow, and then if you change it, I'm fine if it stays the same the whole time, but then when you change it sometimes, and then if I'm not supposed to know exactly if it's lead, then in my mind it's hard for me to go to where to switch the quick, quick, you know, that.
Right.
I guess I just don't know it well enough to change it.
Right, and any of these like more open things, you're going to typically be slow, quick, quick. So you're changing, like when once we get to here, instead of slow, quick, quick, now we change to slow, quick, quick. And then at the very end, to be able to do what you're doing, you have to do a syncopation. And the way that you know is that I speed you up in your turn, right? So if I wanted you to do a slow turn, right?
Okay.
But if I want you to do a syncopated turn while I am doing my syncopated step, yeah, see, I'm turning.
As soon as I speed my step up, I'm just automatically.
Yeah, so I'll lead you once. Okay, so you're just gonna be side by side, and you're gonna step forward actually with your right foot. So this is opposite of what you're used to. And if I do a slow turn, you can see the hand is just slowly circling around you. But if I wanted you to speed up, as soon as you took this step, I would turn the hand quicker.
Right.
Right?
And, yeah, because this way back in my...
Yeah, because you're moving your feet quicker, so, yeah. And there's a quicker, like, stirring of the hand over her head. Yeah. Yeah, much better. Yeah. Dig in. Yeah. Rushing a little bit on the side together. Slow, quick, slow, quick. And you know what I think would be really useful for you just to slow you down is make sure that when your feet pass, that you actually kind of brush them. So it's brush, so it's slow, quick, slow. Yeah, and that slows you down because it's easy to kind of right, move through there quicker, but if I'm doing 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, right, that helps to get a clear rhythm on the spots where you want to brush. You kind of take a little shortcut. I mean, where you want to go faster, you tend to take a little shortcut with your step, and it doesn't kind of pass through next to the other one.
Let's wait till Yeah. That's a lot.
Good timing. Step, brush, step, brush, side, close. Step, brush, step, brush, side, close. Step, brush, step, brush. This song's a little hard to hear. Step, brush, step, brush, side. We turn this one up just a little bit.
You know what I mean? So it's kind of like a down thing to actually, oh, live my life. And you understand that. You understand. So that means that where you
step, brush, side together. Step, brush, side together. Step, brush, side together. Step, brush, side together. Step. Oop. That time you just didn't change feet when you brought them together.
Okay.
Yeah. But that brushing action just to help keep the rhythm, because it gives you something to do on each beat.
Yeah, harmonize. So step, brush.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And then turn it.
Yeah, and actually you're going to turn it after that, so it's still going to go this way. And when I do that second brush, do you see how it turns right after? So instead of like going this way, and then do you see how my foot is now turned that direction? I'm still going to keep it pointing the same in promenade. Step, brush. And it's not till the side together. And so when you're walking out this way, step, brush, side. So it's not until the side together, instead of, you see how I turn in, and I lose some of the movement. So it makes it a little bit more fluid than using your foot to turn in ahead of that.
Yeah.
The music, yeah. Brush, step, brush, side, close, step, brush, side, up.
It does feel like I'm turning your sleeve.
Yeah, so I think when you, so if I wanted to turn, because you're trying to get like a quarter turn around there, so as I brush and come through, do you see where the turn, but the turn comes, so as this one comes out, it curves, then I finish the rotation on the side together, so it's a little bit more subtle. So I think you did it all at the very end. Yeah. So if you step forward here, and after this one brushes, it's going to start curving. Yeah. Uh-huh. But now you're still kind of taking it over that way, and that's where her foot is. So if you want it to go, start going in this curve. So your foot is still, you're turning your foot, but your foot is still moving in the same spot. I'm actually taking my foot in a little curve to the right. Now, so just make sure that there is a space right here, so because you want to step between her feet, so her foot's got to have a spot. So you're still doing that. Do you see how now you actually step on her foot? Yeah, there you go. Because it's easy when your right foot is turning or stepping with the right foot, turn to the right. When your left foot's stepping, you turn to the left. So after I take this brush, I'm going to, do you see how I'm curving? So now she's backing in that direction, and it kind of moves you out of my way a little bit more.
Okay, so something in terms of pivoting her instead of just curving
into it, yeah. Yeah, so I think, yeah, but I think you still took your foot in the same spot, but just turned the foot. You see how I'm actually, probably it'd be good to kind of exaggerate it. So move the foot over rightward. So when you step forward here, and now I'm going to go, yeah, so now step over here, yeah. You see how that's different? You were still stepping this way and just turning your toe instead of actually moving into that curve.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, let's try that.
Yeah. And it's probably a little easier if you're closer together, because when you're further apart, you know, it's a little harder to get around each other. Yeah, so your foot still went that way instead of. So you might just exaggerate it coming around the corner there. So actually moving as you take the. And I still think that you want, and that's why you're getting close to her foot, is that. My foot's turning out that way, but now I'm actually going to step over there. So I'm stepping between her feet instead of stepping forward and turning my heel. Yeah. So I'm just going to move in. I really think about stepping right underneath you. Yeah. That was better. I would say that one is a little late again. Let me try it with you.
Okay.
So right there, we should have already been turning. Now turn this way.
Okay. Okay.
One time?
Yeah.
You don't have to work as hard, right? I think what you were doing was harder. Which is good to know. This is Yeah.
You then allow yourself to go.
That one was probably not as turned as the one. Yeah. Kind of want to turn the foot instead of actually. So actually think about stepping. If this is forward, step off into the diagonal. Yeah, that's it. That's what I needed to say all along.
And then, I don't know what else we should.
It's just like, I think it's good to get that feel of the rhythm with the music for him.
Yeah.
Because it's hard, especially when you add in more and more things to it. If you're not, you know, in sync with the rhythm and with the music, it just becomes more and more difficult. Yeah. Yeah. Nice. There you go. So I just needed to tell you to step into that diagonal. Nice. Yeah. Got it.
Let me do it a couple more times.
Behind there, yeah. Yep. Because you get there on a slow, or excuse me, you get there on a quick, and then you have to move right on the next slow. Slow. Quick, quick, slow. Slow. Quick, slow. Slow. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick. Yeah. Quick, quick. Yep. But yeah, so you got used to it. A lot of times, like, when you learned it, you probably went to that point and stopped, and then you added on, and that happens a lot in my classes, and then you get used to stopping there, and it's like, whoa.
Right, you're learning chunks.
Yes, yes.
And I really try to push, because I really like when we learn something new, to keep tying with the previous step, so you learn it as a flow.
Yeah, that's what I usually do, yeah. Yeah, because then you're just thinking about too many things. Uh-oh, did you get some water? Slow, quick, quick, step, rush, side together. Step, rush, quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. Quick and quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick. Nice. Slow. Quick. Yeah, you didn't finish your side together first before. So the side together completed. Slow. Step brush, side together. Step brush, step brush, side together. Step brush, step brush, side together. Step. So you know what you did do that time? I think that threw it just a little bit. Your side together. So you were doing a promenade, and then you did like a little half side together that was quicker than the music. So it got you out of sync, and that's what I was saying. You know, and then you were both in like different places. So that's why I was saying it's so important to have that.
Head foot disconnect still.
Yeah. You're thinking about the next thing that you want to do, and so you kind of rush that one because your mind's already in the future. Yeah, yeah. So it's just drilling over and over. Quick, quick, slow, quick. Quick, slow, quick and quick.
Thinking me out.
Yeah. Okay. Because, right, because you could do that again the other way, so you don't really know which one he's going to do at that point. Got your shoes?
Yeah.
Because we can just keep doing those like we do with some of the other dances. We can just keep doing these. Ideas.
Yep.
Yeah, just keep going.
Mm-hmm. And let me just say one thing about that turn, just to help you, because when you're getting a little bit out of balance at the end of the turn, and then it's hard to get in position to lead the next thing, you know, and then she's not going to have enough time. So when you're here and you do slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick. So I really just turn, yeah. So if I stopped it right there, you see I turn to this position, and then if I wanted to do another one, you can see where that lead comes in. And then if I did, do you feel the difference in it? So then I just stay towards you to lead that turn. I didn't turn away from you. So, and I think when I do that turn, just a couple of things. My first step is a heel that goes this way. My second step, I try to get it around so I'm slightly looking backwards. And then I turn towards her. Then I complete the turn all the way as I take that next step. Right? And then if I... Right, so... Mm-hmm. So then you can tell in enough time what's coming up.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, and so I'm going from the heel on the first step. Heel. Uh-huh. And, you know, just getting used to this feeling where you see I'm kind of turning through the balls of the feet. So... Uh-huh, that was better. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So I've got the heel to toe. So I should be able to be balanced and then push myself off. Yeah, and you see right there at the end, your left heel wanted to drop down, and that's what kind of tends to throw you back this way. So I want to make sure that instead of dropping down, it's actually pushing up to push me out of that foot. Heel, toe, push, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and so this step, I'm going to think when I land, I think that you can get a little bit more pivot. Yeah, that was better. Between the first and the second, and then make sure that your feet are close enough to where you can pivot, and then I'm going to push out of that left ball of the foot. Push, yeah. Uh-huh. Push. And when I push, I just kind of let this leg pull through, and then I'm ready to go for the next part.
So I'm pushing up.
Yep. And then if I land more oriented to my partner instead of already here, yeah, because this is a harder spot to land. It's easier to land a little bit sideways. So when I come out slow, quick, quick, so quick, quick. Yeah. Then I can finish it, right? But it's easier to balance at that point, moving a little more until she was already, then you kind of took it over that way. So again, you're going to come through. Yeah. And you're both stepping through here. Then becomes a cross. Yes. Yeah. That's good. considering before, it's like getting used to actually being on 2 feet is for some reason that's harder. It's easier for us to want to like put ourselves on 1 foot, and it's harder to balance. So it's easy to want to do this, you know, where you're just like, but if you can get used to being over both feet, it makes it easier, but it's not our natural thing to want to do for some reason. We just want to get off. So if when I step here, do you see both feet are in contact until I take that last step? Yeah. See how you can control that? And we're doing the same thing. So when you're coming around here, you're stepping here, both feet, and then the left one pulls across. So you can see that the left one, and yours is the same with the right, kind of draws across from here to there. So as I step, so you're going left foot to here, and right here I'm on the balls of both feet. And it's usually good to keep your feet a little closer together, because the farther you go, the more you want to drop down. So closer together. And let your feet like do the twist, yeah. Keeping your heels off the floor. And then as I continue to turn, yeah, this right one's gonna push and the left one kind of draws across. Yeah. So now I'm not too far away from you. If I down and down. right? Yeah, because your arms are too far away and I lose control. So if you watch the center here, I'm doing that, something different there. Instead of the tip. Here, I'm keeping it close to us. And then we know that's the center point that we rotate around. So neither one of us is too far away from that center point. So if I go over there and you go over there, we could just pull, pull each other off balance. How I brought that hand down.
Step, not quite right, so I'm doing everything else.
and the old record, everything else was really nice. Yeah, there's like, there's a lot of little things. And instead of like scooping it around here, I'm just gonna go here and straight up around her. And that's another way I get it to go quicker. Instead of going, working on your turn too, and you get more control out of that turn. So your turn kind of is back this way, and then you pull your arm through. Yeah. Let me just do the turn. I really like how you're doing that part that you're separating though, that you're keeping a nice distance here. Yeah, control.